गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू दि ऑनलाइन माइक्रोप्रोसेसर एंड माइक्रो कंट्रोलर वीडियो लेक्चर्स। द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड दैट इज अबाउट द असेंबलर डायरेक्टिव्स, इन विच वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द 9 असेंबलर डायरेक्टिव्स। एंड हियर वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू द सेम टॉपिक, दैट इज असेंबलर डायरेक्टिव्स विद द 2 मोर असेंबलर डायरेक्टिव्स। Assembler directive is nothing but, these are the short form of English words which will give the directions to the assembler to understand the assembly language and to create the proper machine code for the given assembly language. So that means what? These are the assembler directives which will give the directions to the assembler so that assembler will understand the assembly language and it will convert into the code language, that is machine language. Assembler is what? Assembler is a program which converts assembly language into machine language. Assembly language, the program assembly language is going to be programmed by the programmer and it has to be converted into machine language. And that will be possible by the assembler, it is a program. The definition of the assembler directives: assembler is a program which converts assembly language into machine language. In conversion of assembly language to the machine language, this assembler will get this some directions from the short form of English words which are named as assembler directives. The last class we have discussed the 9 assembler directives, and we are going to close this assembly directives with the discussion of 2 more which are very, very important in the examination point of view. So one question can be asked from this topic, that may be long answer question and short answer question also. Short answer question you may be asked like, give the difference between the procedure and macros. These 2 are the assembler directives. Then you are going to ask a question, compare this procedure and macros. Otherwise, in long answer question, you can ask it, the question is that, explain the procedure and macros in detail in 8086 microprocessor. Then I am going with the procedure and the macros. These are the assembler directives which will give the direction to the assembler when it is converting assembly language into the machine language. While executing some instructions, and these procedures and macros are going to give some instructions to the assembler, directions to the assembler. And what exactly the procedures and macros? In general, what we read the program, assembly language program, or we study the assembly language program from the books, which are very, very simple programs only. When we compare that programs with the program for a complex specification. That means what? Whatever we are studying, whatever we are studying the assembly language program from the textbooks, which are very, very simple. But when you compare this program, when you are comparing this simple program, when you are writing very lengthy program, and it is very, very simple. But in practical cases, you have to write the very lengthy program for a complex functions. So that by having the lengthy program, it can have some disadvantages. If your program is very lengthy program, for a complex task or a complex function, you are writing a lengthy program, that can have these 4 disadvantages. If the assembly language program is very lengthy one, then that can have the 4 disadvantages. That means what? The programmer has to write the lengthy program with the large number of instructions. Second one, if the program is very lengthy one and it is requiring the many number of instructions, so that it requires the more memory also. And again, it is very difficult to identify the errors and to understand the instructions also, to understand the program also. So I hope I am very, very clear that in practical, if you are going to write the assembly language program for a complex task, so that program will be very lengthy. If you are allowed that lengthy program, that can have the four disadvantages. It requires the more memory, it is difficult to understand the error, it is difficult to understand the program, it is difficult to identify the errors, and again the programmer will find very difficult in order to remember all those instructions. To avoid this problem, we are going to reduce the length of the program. We are going to reduce the length of the program by using the sub-programs are named as procedures and macros. Here, what is the necessity of procedures and macros? Procedure and macros, nothing but assembler directives, which are going to reduce the length of the assembly language program. So that if the length is going to reduce, then no need to write that much of program, no need, that doesn't require that much of memory, and it is very easy to understand the code, and it is easy to understand the errors. So that if the program is lengthy one, and that the length of the program can be reduced by making use of two assembler directives, that is named as a procedure and a macro. Length of the program can be reduced by making use of the assembler directives that are named as procedure and macros. Then how can we reduce that by making use of procedures? For example, I'm having some 100 lines of a program. In which I found that some 10 instructions, some 10 group of instructions are coming several times. That 10 group of instructions are coming 3-4 times. So that every time I should not write that 10 instructions. If I write every time 10 instructions, that will be the 100 instructions. So that what I am doing, I am keeping these 10 instructions in the memory. Whenever my main program is required, that instruction will be called by the processor, such that is going to execute. So that what we are going to do, that we are going to identify the several, we are going to identify some set of or some group of instructions which are repeatedly coming for a same task in the same program. So that we are taking that set of instructions and we are residing them in the memory, and whenever these instructions required, so that program control directly goes to that particular set of instructions, so that they call those instructions, they will execute, such that again it comes back to the main program and it is going to execute. And these are nothing but procedure and macros. Procedure is nothing but what? In a large program, if the several instructions are coming repeatedly for the same function in the main program, then that will be formed into the sub program, that are going to set as a sub program in the memory or in the main program also. If that set of instructions, several set of instructions are repeatedly coming, and then if we store that is in the memory, that are named as procedure. If that instructions are coming repeatedly and we are storing that in the main program itself only, we are defining main program, this several program one, several instructions once in the main program, that is called macro. I am explaining the same. You have to remember the very, very important point. Procedures and macros, nothing but these are the assembly directives which are going to reduce the length of a program. That means what? In the program, if some group of instructions are coming repeatedly, they are going to define in sub program, and that program may be either called as procedure or macro. If that program is defined, if that repeatedly coming instructions, we are calling it is a sub program. If that sub program is defined in the memory, then that is named as procedure. If that sub program is defined in the main program itself, that is called macro. This is very, very important point. Length of the program for a complex task has been reduced by the two assembler directives that are nothing but procedures and macros. The procedures and macros nothing but what? These are the sub programs which is having repeated instructions in the program, repeated instructions in the main program, and this group of repeated instructions in the main program, if we keep them in the main memory, that is called procedure. If these repeated instructions in the main program, if we define that is in the main program itself, that is called macro. Then I am going with the here we are going to have the first one is called procedure. Procedure is a one assembler directive. It is one assembler directive. So that in the program, if there are several instructions are repeatedly coming for the same specific function in the main program, then that will be keep aside by giving one particular name, that is named as procedure. Procedure, we are giving the name for the procedure, and that will keep in the main memory, and while the main program is going to be executed, when it reaches to that particular program by using the procedure, by using the call instruction, program controller directly goes to that particular memory location, so that it calls the instruction which are there in the procedure assembler directive. It calls those such that it execute them, and again it comes back to execute the main function. Here we are having, I'm going with the procedure. Procedure is nothing but when a group of instructions are to be used several times, to perform a same function in the main program. That means what? These are the set of instructions we have been using several times to perform the same function in the main program. Then we can write them as a separate program. We will make separate them into a separate program. That program is named as procedure or sub program or subroutine. Whenever we require this set of instructions, we will use the instruction that is call, C-A-L-L, call. So that we are going to call whatever the instructions are there in the procedure, such that all instruction comes to the main program, so that program control is going to execute that one. After executing that one, that program controller come back to the main program again. So here, the procedure written and assembled as a separate program modules, and it is stored in the memory. Just now we discussed that will be stored in the memory, and when the procedure is called in the main program, the program control transferred to the memory or the procedure, and it executes those instructions. Again it comes back to the main program by using another instruction that is called return. Here there are two instructions required to go for the procedure assembler directive and to come back from the assembler directive, that is called procedure. That means I am going with the procedure example here. This fact is nothing but it is a procedure name. That means what is the procedure? Is nothing but assembler directive, and which is having the name is fact. And here procedure, it is defined with some several set of instructions, so that so that the program controller, the program controller is come to here such that it execute these instructions. After executing this instruction, we are using one more assembler directive that is called endp, is nothing but end program or end procedure. After executing these instructions in the procedure, again program control comes to back to the main program, and this can be explained like this. For example, this is the main program. Here this is a main program which is having around 100 instructions. By defining its procedure, it is divided into the, it is converted into 40 instructions only. Assume that here this is total of 100. By defining the procedure, it is going to convert into the 40 instructions, because the length of the program will be reduced by the procedures and macros. These are two assembler directives. So that the program control has been executing these instructions. So one by one it has been executing an instruction. Then it reached the instruction that is call. Call means what? It has to call the instructions which are there in the subprogram. That subprogram is nothing but procedure. So that program controller directly goes to the memory where it finds the procedure in which it finds the instructions which resides in the name of program 1. And it is going to execute those instructions. It is going to execute this instruction. Again, it will find the one more assembler directive such that it comes back to the main program. And again it comes back to the main program and it is going to execute some more functions. For example, here also this is having one more program, that is procedure, so that again it comes back to the same set of instruction, that is procedure and program 1, and it is going to have some set of instructions. After executing that set of instructions, and it is going to get the assembly directive that is written, so that it comes back to the main program. That means what? Instead of writing here 20 instructions, here 20 more instructions, at a time we are defining 20 instructions in the memory, so that we are going to reduce the size of the main program. If the size of the main program is reduced, obviously memory required for that program is going to reduce, and it is easily understood by the program, and it is easily written by the programmer, and we can identify the errors very easily if we define a subprogram in the main program. Subprogram is nothing but either it may be procedure or macro. Here in calling the procedure, we are using the instruction that is called. After executing the instructions in the procedure, to come back to the main program, we are using the instruction that is called return. So that in case of procedure assembler directive, we are using the two instructions. One is call. Call is nothing but by seeing this call, the program controller directly transfer to the memory, where it can find the procedure, and that procedure it is going to execute those instructions, and by getting the one more instruction, that is written, and it comes back to the main program to execute the remaining instructions which are there in the main program. This is nothing but the functionality of procedure. And here the procedure, this is the procedure structure, and this is the procedure name, and this is a procedure and we are telling that it is a assembler directive procedure. It is going to have some set of instructions, and after executing this one, we are going to have the return, and that will be, after that return, it going to have the end program or end procedure. This is about the procedures. And coming to the next one, we are having the two calling instructions. To call the procedure, we are having the two calling instructions. One is a near call instruction, another one is far call instruction. That means what? If the main program and the procedure is resides in the same logical segment, then that we can make use the near call instruction. That means what? We know the segments, we have the segment, that is, what are the segments we have? data segment, extra segment, code segment. If the subprogram and the main program, subprogram and the main program is defined in the same logical segment, then we can use the instruction to call the procedure, that is called near call. It is very, very clear that near call is an instruction when the main program and the procedure, that is nothing but the subprogram, is defined in the same logical segment, then that instruction is, we can make use, that is a near call. Far call is nothing but here the procedure is defined. Procedure is defined in data segment, whereas main program is defined in the code segment. That means what? Procedure is defined in the, procedure resides in the data segment, whereas main program resides in the code segment, so that we can make use to call the procedure instructions, that is far call. That means what? The code segment has to go to the data segment to have the instructions in the procedure, that is subprogram, so that it can execute them. And after getting the assembler directive, that is written, and it is come back to the main program, where the main program is there in the code segment. So that there has been used there to accomplish the procedure, we are using the two instructions. One is call, another one is return. But in the call instructions, we can make use the two types of call instructions. One is near call instruction, another one is far call instruction. If the main program and the subprogram, that is nothing but procedure, is resides are defined in the same logical segment, and that instruction we can make use, that is near instruction. If the main program is defined in one logical segment, if the procedure is defined in another logical segment, then we can make use the instruction that is called far call. So likewise, you can have the two types of call instructions to call the procedure. One is near call, another one is far call. And we are going to have the two types, we are going to have the two types of procedures. So in the procedures, we are having the two types. One is nothing but it is re-entrant procedure, and another one is recursive procedure. Re-entrant procedure. There are two types of procedures. Re-entrant procedure, another one is recursive procedure. That means what? In re-entrant procedure, we are going to have the more than one procedures we have to execute. That means what? Here this is a main program. Assume that this is a main program, and here we are executing some instruction. It founds the procedure one, so that by using the call instruction, it goes to the procedure one, and again it is while executing this procedure one instructions, it is going to find the procedure two, such that it is goes to the procedure two, it execute, and it come back to here, and it execute the remaining instructions in the procedure one, and it come back to here, and such that it execute the remaining things. That means what? In entrant procedure, in the entrant procedure, we can have more than one procedure that has to be executed to execute the total program. Whereas a recursive program, we are going to have only one procedure. It has to execute it repeatedly with the n number of times until n is equals to 0. For example, if you are having n is equals to 2, then we have to execute first level, and after that we have to execute the second level. So with that, this recursive procedure instructions will be called, such that they will be executed. Here this is very, very important. There are two types of procedures are there. First one is re-entrant procedure, more than one procedure defined in the main memory, such that while it is executing the main memory, while it is executing the main program, it is going to found the program procedure one, such that it is program control goes transferred to that procedure one, and while executing the procedure one, it is going to get the procedure two also. It has to execute the procedure two, and it should come back to the procedure one. After executing the procedure one, it has to come back to the main program. That is called, it is re-entrant procedure. Next one is recursive procedure. Is nothing but we are going to have only one procedure. that is subprogram such that until it makes to, until n is equals to 0, n is nothing but a level of processor executions, until n is equals to 0 it has to be executed. For n is equals to 2 means what? Here 1 and 2, 2 times it has been executing the same procedure. Same procedure is nothing but it is a set of several instructions which are repeatedly coming in the main program to perform the same function. And here this is about reentrant and this one is recursive. Next we can go with the macros. Macros is nothing but very simple. Here in the procedure we will have some large number of instruction. In the procedure is nothing but subprogram. We can have the very lengthy instructions even in the procedure also. But whereas in the case of macros, it is going to have very less number of instruction. It is also subprogram, but it is with very less number of instruction compared to the procedure. And whereas the procedure will define in the memory, whereas macros will define in the main program itself only. Whenever it calls the macro, whenever in assembly language program it gets the instruction about the macro, and directly whatever the instructions are defined in the macro subprogram, that will be inserted here such that program controller is going to execute the same. It no need to go for the memory, because macro is nothing but it is a subprogram. It is defined in the main program itself only, so that whenever the assembler controller finds this macro, such that it inserts the whatever the instructions are defined in the main assembly language program, such that it is going to execute those instructions. And this is about macros, and we are going to have the comparison between the macros. I am going with the introduction of the macros. When the group of instructions are to be used several times to perform a same function in a program, and they are too small, these are too small, be written as procedure, they can be defined as macro. And to call the instructions in the macros, we will be using the two directives, that is macro and endm. Macro, we are using the two directives. First one is macro, another one is NDM. That means what? Whenever the assembler control find the assembler directive, that is macro, that means what? It has to insert whatever the instructions which are defined in the macro subprogram, such that it is going to insert those instructions which are defined in the macro subprogram, so that those instructions will be executed by the program control. So that whenever it reaches the endm, so that it is going to complete the execution of the instructions which are defined in the macro subprogram. The macros are identified by their names only. The name usually defined at the time of the start of a program. Before going to start a program only, these macros will be defined in the main program, such that whenever assembler control or assembler finds this particular macro name, directly it insert the whatever the instructions are defined in the starting of the program in a macro, that will be executed first. So the macro is called by their names in the program. Whenever macro is called in the program, the assembler will insert the defined group of instruction in the place of a call. That means every time the assembler see a macro name in the program, replace it with the group of instructions defined as macro. And the same program we can go with the here. Macro is nothing but these are too small to compare to the procedure, and the macro here, macro name, and we can give the name of macro, that may be any name, and we are specifying it is a macro, so that assembler control will find this macro, such that it inserts whatever the instructions are defined in the macro subprogram, and that will inserted here, such that execute that one, and after that one the program control or assembly control find this one end m, so that it goes to the main program again. It is going to execute the instructions of main program, such that it requires that the execution of the procedure takes much time than the execution of macro instructions, so that execution of macro instructions is very very fast compared to the procedure. Here we can have the comparison between the procedure and macro. First point in the comparison between the procedure and macro: procedures are used for long sequence of instructions, more than 10 instructions. That means what we just now we discussed, that is procedure is nothing but it is a sub program. It can be defined with the large number of instruction, at least with the 10 instruction, whereas macro can be defined with the less number of instruction. It is also sub program, and procedure requires the call and return instruction. Just now we discussed the procedure requires the call and return instructions, whereas macros does not require the call and return instruction, because directly by seeing the name of, by seeing the macro, the assembler directive or the assembler control is going to insert the instructions whatever there in the macro, such that that will be inserted, such that the assembler control is going to program control is going to execute the same instruction. Procedure executes slower than compared to the macros. We know that control of execution is transferred to the procedure. That means what? Here control of execution, by seeing this one, control of execution will be transferred to the memory, such that it execute and it come back to the seer. But in case of macro, whenever it finds the macro controller, that is what the program controller is going to insert these instructions, so that it is not going to the out from the microprocessor, it is getting the instructions from the macro inside only, so that control execution remains in the main program only, because macro is defined in the main program, that is starting of the main program itself only, so that it is the comparison between the procedure and macros. With this, the procedure and macros topic is completed. You should remember only one point in the procedure and macros, that is procedure and macros nothing but these are the sub programs. Also, these are the assembler directives which are going to direct the assembler in conversion of assembly language to the machine language. And these, whenever the program is a lengthy program, and that length of the program can be reduced by making use of the two sub programs, that is called procedure and macro. That means what? Some set of instructions, some group of instructions, if you are getting several times in the same program for a same function, and so that we can take them from the main program, such that we can keep somewhere, that may be inside the microprocessor or in the main memory or outside the microprocessor, that is in the memory, so that will be is if you are keeping that set of instructions in the main program itself, that is called macro. If you are keeping that set of instructions which are coming repeatedly, if you keep that is in the memory, that is called procedure. So there are two types of instructions required for the procedure: call and return. And in call instruction, we are having the two more types of instructions: near call and far call. And these procedure is having the two more types, that is re-entrant procedure and recursive procedure. Likewise, you have to explain the procedure and macros for the 10 marks. This is very very important in the examination point of view. In the tomorrow's class, we are going to start the interfacing of 8086 microprocessor with the external interfaces devices, like 8255 peripheral devices, like that you can go with the interfacing of 8086 microprocessor. Thank you.